This channel has been established for visually impaired people. For the visually impaired people, voice narration and a written expression are also provided for the hearing impaired. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. The Good Earth is a 1937 American drama film about Chinese farmers who struggle to survive. It was adapted by Talbot Jennings, Tess Schlesinger, and Claudine West from the play by Owen Davis and Donald Davis, which was in itself based on the 1931 novel of the same name by Nobel Prize-winning author Pearl S. Buck. The film was directed by Sidney Franklin, with uncredited contributions by Victor Fleming and Gustave Machete. The film stars Paul Muni as Wong Lung for her role as his wife O Lan. Louise Rainer won an Academy Award for Best Actress. The film also won the Academy Award for Best Cinematography for Carl Freund. It was nominated for Best Director, Best Film Editing and Best Picture. Its world premiere was at the elegant Carthay Circle Theater in Los Angeles. Contents 1 Plot 2 Cast 21 Unbilled 3 Production 4 Reception 5 Box Office 6 Awards and Honors 7 The Good Earth on Turner Classic Movies 71 Introduction by Robert Osborne 8 Dedication at the start of opening credits 9 Introduction at the end of opening credits 10 See also 11 References 12 External links Plot in pre-World War I Northern China, a young farmer Wong Lung Paul Muni marries O Lan Louise Rainer, a lowly servant at the Great House, the residence of the most powerful family in their village O Lan proves to be an excellent wife, hard-working and uncomplaining Wong Lung prospers he buys more land, and O Lan gives birth to 2 sons and a daughter. Meanwhile, the Great House begins to decline. All is well until a drought and the resulting famine drive the family to the brink. Desperate, Wong Lung considers the advice of his pessimistic, worthless uncle Walter Connolly to sell his land for food, but O Lan opposes it instead. They travel south to a city in search of work. The family survives by begging and stealing when a revolutionary gives a speech to try to drum up support for the army approaching despite rain in the north. Wong Lung and O Lan realize the drought is over. They long to return to their farm, but they have no money for an ox, seed, and food. The city changes hands, and O Lan joins a mob looting a mansion. However, she is knocked down and trampled upon when she comes to. She finds a bag of jewels overlooked in the confusion. This windfall allows the family to go home and prosper once more. O Lan asks only to keep 2 pearls for herself. Years pass. Wong Lung's sons grow up into educated young men, and he has grown so wealthy that he purchases the Great House. Then, Wong Lung becomes besotted with Lotus Tilly Losh, a pretty, young dancer at the local tea house, and makes her his second wife. He begins to find fault with the worn-out O Lan. Desperate to gain affection from Lotus, he gives O Lan's pearls to Lotus. When Wong Lung discovers that Lotus has seduced younger son Roland Louis, he orders his son to leave. Then a swarm of locusts threatens the entire village using a strategy devised by elder son Kai Luke. Everyone unites to try to save the crops. Just when all seems lost, the wind shifts direction, taking the danger away. The near disaster brings Wong Lung back to his senses. He reconciles with younger son on the latter's wedding day. Wong Lung returns the pearls to O Lan before she dies. Exhausted by a hard life without disturbing the wedding festivities, Wong Lung quietly exits the house and regards a flowering peach tree planted by O Lan on their marriage day. Reverently he murmurs, "O Lan, you are the earth." Cast Paul Muni as Wong Tilly Losh as Lotus, Louise Rainer as O Lan, Charlie Grapeuan as Old Father, Walter Connolly as Uncle Jesse, Ralph as Cuckoo, Su Yong as Aunt Kai, Luke as Elder Son, Roland Louis as Younger Son, Susanna Kim as Little Fool, Ching Hua Lee as Ching, Harold Huber as Cousin, Olaf Hitton as Lou Grain Merchant, William Law as Gateman, Mary Wong as Little Bride, Unbilled Charles Middleton Banker, Chester Gon Singer in Tea House, Richard Liu Farmer, Cam Tong Peasant, Victor Sen Young Peasant, Philip On Revolutionary Army Captain, Bessie Liu, Clarence Lung, Sammy Tong. Production. The film's budget was $28 million, a small fortune at the time, and took 3 years to make. A 500-acre farm in Porter Ranch, California, was transformed into a replica of Chinese farmland. For this film, the movie script was more sympathetic to China than the novel had been. Wong Lung's son was now a representative of modern China who goes to university and leads the villagers. The family is a wholesome, affectionate unit. Even the uncle who in the novel exploits Wong Lung, and the sexual aspect of Lotus is played down. The Hayes office, which supervised each Hollywood script, demanded more than 20 rewrites to eliminate what it found offensive before Herbert Stothart and Edward Ward were engaged to provide the music. Negotiations took place with Austrian composer Arnold Schoenberg, who is known to have made some musical sketches for the score before the plan fell through. Pearl Buck intended the film to be cast with all Chinese or Chinese-American actors. Irving Thalberg also envisioned casting only Chinese actors, but had to consider concede that American audiences were not ready for such a film, though Anna May Wong had been suggested for the role of O-Lan. The Hays Code anti-miscegenation rules required Paul Muni's character's wife to be played by a white actress. MGM offered Wong the role of Lotus, but she refused, stating, "You're asking me, with Chinese blood, to do the only unsympathetic role in the picture featuring an all-American cast portraying Chinese characters. Many of the characters were played by Western actors made to look Asian with aid of makeup techniques developed by Jack Don and used for the first time in this film. However, some of the supporting cast did include Chinese American actors." When MGM inquired into the possibility of making the film in China, the Chinese government was divided on how to respond. Initial hostility derived from resentment of the novel, which critics charged focused only on the perceived backwardness of the country, while some government officials hoped to have control, which would be gone if the film work was done outside China. Generalissimo Chiang Kai-shek himself intervened, perhaps at the behest of his wife, Mi Chang, whose American education made her an advocate for cooperation. Permission was granted on condition that the view of China be favorable, that Chinese government would supervise and have approval of shots done in China, and the unenforced stipulation that the entire cast be Chinese. The government in Nanjing did not foresee the sympathy the film would create, and when MGM decided to shoot on location in China, officials took extraordinary steps to control the production, forcing the studio to hire a nationalist general to advise them on authentic settings and costumes. Most of this footage was mysteriously lost when it was shipped home and had to be reshot in California. There were reports that MGM distributed a different version of the film in China. The film's 1936 production lasted from February 28 to July 23. Thalberg died on September 14, 4.5 months before its Los Angeles premiere on January 29, 1937. The film credits stated that this was his last great achievement. Reception contemporary reviews were positive. Frank S. Nugent of the New York Times praised the film as a superb translation of a literary classic, one of the finest things Hollywood has done this season or any other. While it has taken some liberties with the novel's text, it has taken none with its quality or spirit. Variety declared it a remarkable screen production and called Muni's performance splendid, but questioned whether the subject matter would make for good box office. Film Daily raved, a must-see picture, possessing absorbing drama, passionate sincerity and brilliant performance. John Mosier of The New Yorker called it a vast and rich film. Harrison's Reports described it as a highly artistic piece of work, and while not exactly an entertaining picture, those who see it will undoubtedly be awed by its magnificence. Box office, according to MGM, records the film earned $2,002,000 in the US and Canada and $1,555,000 elsewhere, but because of its high cost incurred an ultimate loss of $96,000. Awards and honors. The Good Earth was nominated for a total of 5 Academy Awards, including Best Picture, Best Direction Sidney Franklin, Best Cinematography Carl Freund, and Best Film Editing Basil Rangel, in addition to the Best Actress Award Louise Rainer. The film won for Best Cinematography. The film is recognized by American Film Institute in these lists: 2003, AFI's 100 Years 100 Heroes; 2005, AFI's 100 Years of Film Scores, nominated; 2006, AFI's 100 Years 100 Cheers, nominated. The Good Earth on Turner Classic Movies. The Good Earth's TCM showing on October 7, 2015 was part of a tribute to Academy Award for Best Cinematography. Black and White nominees. The 4 films screened after The Good Earth winner were 1941's Citizen Kane nominee, 1956's Somebody Up There Likes Me winner, 1966's Who's Afraid of Virginia Woolf winner, and 1943's Air Force nominee. Introduction by Robert Osborne. "Hi, I'm Robert Osborne. You know, as much as I love color films, and have been bedazzled by the color in movies like The Red Shoes, Blood and Sand, 1940s, The Thief of Baghdad, Ziegfeld Follies of 1946, I have to say there isn't anything more beautiful than a great black and white movie. To me, something about the play of light and shadow draws me into a film more than color cinematography does." Well, film historian and author Wheeler Winston Dixon agrees on that subject, and he says so emphatically in this slim new book called Black and White Cinema, A Short History. It's a book that looks at black and white cinematography from its origins through its heyday. It's also a book that inspired our lineup of films for the next few hours, those films being some of the most beautiful black and white films ever made. Well, our first black and white film on this October Wednesday is one which earned cinematographer Carl Freund an Academy Award for his work It's the Good Earth from MGM in 1937, made 8 years after Freund immigrated to Hollywood from Germany, where he learned his craft in the German film industry before World War II broke out. Freund had already photographed dozens of films, including the landmark German film Metropolis. Well, in Hollywood, he first made waves with Universal's black and white horror classic Dracula. By the time he made this next film about the Good Earth, he was under contract to MGM in Hollywood, which meant he had the full power of the Tiffany of movie studios for support in telling this story. The Good Earth stars Paul Muni and Louise Rainer and is an adaptation of the novel by Pearl S. Buck, all about the struggles of family of farmers in rural China. It was one of the last movies made by MGM production chief Irving Thalberg, before his sudden death in 1936. Thalberg was a workaholic and poured himself into every detail of his productions, and, for this film, he sent an expedition of researchers to China to search for 18 tons of furniture, farm equipment and other authentic material. Thalberg then had a walled city build a farm near Chatsworth, California, complete with a man-made river and fields filled with real Chinese vegetables. I mean, it was a mammoth, multi-million dollar undertaking, and, thanks to Carl Freund's amazing cinematography, you'll be seeing 95% of those dollars right up there on the screen. Here's the movie, from 1937. The Good Earth. Dedication at the start of opening credits to the memory of Irving Grant Thalberg. We dedicate this picture his last great achievement. Introduction at the end of opening credits. The soul of a great nation is expressed in the life of its humblest people. In this simple story of a Chinese farmer may be found something of the soul of China. Tilde its humility, its courage, its deep heritage from the past and its vast promise for the future. See also whitewashing in film. References. Carrot Brown, Gene. 1995 Movie Time, A Chronology of Hollywood and the Movie Industry from Its Beginnings to the Present. New York, Macmillan P. To the New World, Chinese-American Studies in the New Millennium. Altamira, 2002, pp. 277-79, 283-84. Carrot Hay, Peter. MGM, When the Lion Roars. Carrot Nugent, Frank S. February 3, 1937, Movie Review, The Good Earth. The New York Times. The New York Times Company retrieved August 31, 2015. Carrot AFI's 100 Years 100 Cheers nominees PDF retrieved 14 August 2016. The Probation Wife 1919. The Heart of Wetona 1919. The Hoodlum 1919. Heart o' the Hills 1919. Smilin' Through 1922. The Primitive Lover 1922. East is West 1922. Brass 1923. Dulcie 1923. Tiger Rose 1923. Her Night of Romance 1924. Beverly of Graustark 1926. The Duchess of Buffalo 1926. Quality Street 1927. The Actress 1928. Wild Orchids 1929. The Last of Mrs. Cheney 1929. Devil May Care 1929. The Lady of Scandal 1930. A Lady's Morals 1930. The Guardsman 1931. Private Lives 1931. Smilin' Through 1932. Reunion in Vienna 1933. The Barretts of Wimpole Street 1934. The Dark Angel 1935. The Good Earth 1937. The Barretts of Wimpole Street 1957. V. E. Irving Thalberg Producer. Foolish Wives 1922. Merry Go Round 1923. The Hunchback of Notre Dame 1923. His Hour 1924. He Who Gets Slapped 1924. Greed 1924. The Unholy Three 1925. The Merry Widow 1925. The Tower of Lies 1925. The Big Parade 1925. Ben-Hur, A Tale of the Christ 1925. Torrent 1926. La Boheme 1926. Brown of Harvard 1926. The Road to Mandalay 1926. The Temptress 1926. Valencia 1926. Flesh and the Devil 1926. 12 Miles Out 1927. The Student Prince in Old Heidelberg 1927. London After Midnight 1927. The Crowd 1928. Laugh, Clown, Laugh 1928. White Shadows in the South Seas 1928. Show People 1928. West of Zanzibar 1928. The Broadway Melody 1929. The Trial of Mary Duggan 1929. Voice of the City 1929. Where East is East 1929. The Last of Mrs. Cheney 1929. The Hollywood Review of 1929. Hallelujah 1929. His Glorious Night 1929. The Kiss 1929. Anna Christie 1930. Redemption 1930. The Divorcee 1930. The Rogue Song 1930. The Big House 1930. The Unholy Three 1930, Let Us Be Gay 1930, Billy the Kid 1930, Way for a Sailor 1930, A Lady's Morals 1930, Inspiration 1931, Traitor Horn 1931, The Secret Six 1931, A Free Soul 1931, Just a Gigolo 1931, The Sin of Madelon Claudette 1931, The Guardsman 1931, The Champ 1931, Possessed 1931, Private Lives 1931, Mata Hari 1931, Freaks 1932, Tarzan the Ape Man 1932. Grand Hotel 1932, Letty Linton 1932, As You Desire Me 1932, Red Headed Woman 1932, Smilin' Through 1932, Red Dust 1932, Rasputin and the Empress 1932, Strange Interlude 1932, Tugboat Annie 1933, Bombshell 1933, Eskimo 1933, Riptide 1934, The Barretts of Wimpole Street 1934, The Merry Widow 1934, What Every Woman Knows 1934, No More Ladies 1935, China Seas 1935, Mutiny on the Bounty 1935, A Night at the Opera 1935, Riff Raff 1936, Romeo and Juliet 1936, Camille 1936, Maytime 1937, A Day at the Races 1937, Broadway Melody of 1938-1937, The Good Earth 1937, Marie Antoinette 1938, Rider the Trap 1922, People, Norma Shearer, Wife, Irving Thalberg Jr., Son Related, The Love of the Last Tycoon, Authority Control, WorldCat Identities, VIAF, 211,746,716, GND, 4,744,327-3, BNF, CB14661959, C data.